culture. I could, but I'm not. The Bible says it's a shame to speak of those things which are done to them in secret. So I'm not advertising for the devil tonight, but I'm going to point out some things that I believe would be important to you. You know, music is very, very powerful. God can take a good soft stanza, as just as I am, and break a heart and soften somebody and bring them to an altar and change their entire life. And the devil can take his music and cause you to do things you would have never done under normal circumstances. Music is powerful. Experts tell us that in a lot of these big eating establishments, that they'll come in there and they'll have music. You know how they'll pipe music in these places, like a steakhouse or somewhere. And when the crowd is kind of down and there's just a few stragglers sitting in there eating, the music's kind of soft and low. And they say that when that big crowd comes in for lunch and it lines up outside and there's a great big line, they'll go in there and stick another music tape in and say, turn it on. And by that music starts going through there, and the first thing you know, you're going through the line saying, forks and spoons, a knife, napkin, lettuce, tomato, cheese, ham, and you're eating, and the faster they get that music going, the faster you eat and get on out of there and get your money and get rid of you. And so music is used in all kinds of ways by all kinds of people to do all kinds of things. And as the brother said, I got involved in rock and roll music when I was about 10 years old playing a guitar. And everybody and her brother had a band back then when the Beatles were real popular. And we got started, and I got involved with a bunch of older boys. They're 17 and 18. And because of that, we went into places and played, like a lake club, and where people were dancing and getting drunk and swapping wives. And I was only 11 years old, and I played bass guitar, and I remember that. And I saw some things that I shouldn't have saw as an 11-year-old boy. Now, I remember my dad used to haul our equipment around in his pickup truck, and we'd put drums and amplifiers and speakers and wires and musical instruments in there, and Daddy'd be drunk along with everybody else, and we'd go around an old curvy road going home at 12:30 and 1 o'clock in the morning, and I was 11, 12 years old. Remember, I'd reach over and grab the steering wheel, and my daddy's head would be going like this, about ready to run off the road and wreck, and I'd grab it and put it, and I'd say, Dad, wake up! And at an early age, I saw what music and the influence of alcohol and this type of immoral lifestyle can do to a person, and put a fear in me, even though I wasn't saved. And here in the book of Daniel, we're going to read you a verse of scripture in Daniel chapter 3, where the king set up an image and wanted people to worship it. Now, the Bible said in verse 7, therefore at that time when all the people heard the sound of the cornet, flute, harp, sackbut, psaltery, and all kinds of music, all the people, the nations, the languages, fell down and worshiped the golden image that Nebuchadnezzar the king had set up. Look at verse 10. Thou, king, hast made a decree that every man that shall hear the sound of the cornet, flute, harp, sackbut, psaltery, and dulcimer, and all kinds of music, shall fall down and worship the golden image. Now, parents, I want you to get ready tonight. I'm going to be saying some things. I will not say some things that some of you parents are hoping I'm going to say. It's going to be a little bit different. I could preach a message like that. I could start back in 1955 where a disc jockey up in Ohio coined the phrase rock and roll, named Alan Freed, and it was a term to describe backseat fornication in an automobile, and the term rock and roll was born. That's what it means. And the fellow who coined that was a DJ up in Ohio, and it caught on through Jerry Lee Lewis and some of those guys, and Elvis the Pelvis came along about that time. And AC/DC wrote a song a few years ago that described the beginning of the rock religion. And AC/DC's song, the title of it was, Let There Be Rock. What does that sound like to you? Genesis chapter 1, when God began to create. The devil began to create. The song goes like this from AC/DC. We'll see, hear from them in a few minutes. Back in 1955, man didn't know about a rock and roll show and all that jive. The white man had the smarts, the black man had the blues. No one knew what they were going to do, but Joukowsky had the news. And then they say, let there be drums, brrr, let there be guitars, and they play a little bit, let there be this, let there be that, and then let there be rock, and everybody comes in, and they are saying, what God did in Genesis 1, we are doing in 1955. This is the first generation to ever grow up on a steady diet of this type of culture. I won't be able to talk about that much tonight because I'm going a different direction, but rock music has several steps. It started out in the late 50s and early 60s with booze and sex. It moved into the 70s with drugs and rebellion. Now, the way I'm going to get down there on the floor tonight is I'm going to start walking down these steps. I don't just jump. I take one step at a time. In the 1960s, it was drinking, sex. In the 1970s, it was drugs and rebellion. In the 1980s, we are moving to the final stage, which is worship. And a lot of people don't realize that the devil is a religious being and desires worship. You see, the devil is jealous of God for kicking him out of heaven. Now, the devil don't care nothing about you kids. The devil, the only way he knows he can hurt God is to get you, because you're what the Lord loves the most. That's why the devil ain't interested in squirrels and rabbits and pigs and dogs, because the Lord loves you best, and that's why the devil's after you. Now, I want to point two things out to you tonight in this message. And I'm not going to have time to talk about what I'm not here to tell you what kind of music you can listen to and what kind you ain't. You say, I ain't going to listen. He's going to get up there and tell me that I can't listen to my music. I ain't going to tell you nothing. You can listen to whatever you want to. It's a free country. They're your ears, and you can stick whatever you want to in them. I'm not going to try to tell you what you can listen to and what you can't. That's up to you, friend. Every time I talk about this, people come up to me and they say, well, you talked about this group, but what about this group? And what about this group? You're missing the entire point. I'm not going to talk about soft rock tonight. I'm not going to talk about medium rock. I'm not going to talk about all of, I could talk about Journey and Duran Duran and the little girl singing about her boyfriend, I think we're alone now. You know, I could do that. I could get on a whole message on that. And they got one now talking about when her boyfriend comes, woo, you make heaven a place on earth. You know, I'm not going to have time to talk about that. Now, I'll tell you this. If you get right with God, God will tell you what's right and what's wrong. Everywhere I go, people say, well, what about soft rock? What about medium rock? Well, it's like hard liquor and soft liquor. It just takes more soft liquor to kill you. See? But they both have the same long-term effect. And I ain't going to preach about that tonight. I know your parents are probably disappointed because you want me to say something on that, but I'm going a different direction. I have two purposes. Get them good, and we'll start. Number one, my first purpose is to show that the world is more ready to receive the Antichrist than the church is the real Christ. That's part number one. You got that? Now, how many of you know, have ever heard of the Antichrist? Raise your hand. Okay, I'm going to have to explain it. Listen here. You ever heard of Christ? How many heard of Christ? Raise your hand. All right, that's Jesus Christ. I'm glad he's more popular. Hallelujah. All right? You've heard of Christ. Now, what does anti mean? What does freeze mean? What does anti-freeze mean? See, freeze is stopping something from freezing. Antifreeze stops something from being froze. If it ain't froze, it's thawed out. And antifreeze means it won't freeze. Now, antichrist means the opposite of Christ. Whose son was Christ? God. Whose son is the opposite of Christ? The devil. Now listen. We who know the Bible know that we're coming along through here. We're 1960, 1970, we're 1988 right here. Now, sometime in the future right in here, the Lord is going to call everybody that's saved out in what we call the rapture. Now, one of these days, brother, we're going to be gone. See, we're going to disappear. We're going to like zip, man, right through the ceiling and forever be with the Lord. We're going to pass that crowd up down there at Cape Kennedy like it's going backwards, man. That's called the rapture. Now, when the rapture comes, all hell's going to break loose down here. And you've heard of this. You've heard of the moon and of the sun turning to blood and the moon, all this stuff, the sun getting dark, moon turning to blood. And you've heard of the bulls. You've heard of the mark of the beast. How many people ever heard of the mark of the beast? How many of you know what number the beast is? 666. Now, you got to remember that. His number is 666. Now, this guy that's coming to run the show during this time is the devil's son. He's called the Antichrist. He is the exact opposite of Christ, and his job is to get everybody together to follow him in his cause. So what you're getting ready to see is how I'm going to get into the punk rock and heavy metal tonight for all you headbangers, and we're going to give you some of the hardest stuff they are in the world. You ready? We're just going to skip over all the other stuff and get into the stuff that prove the world ready and even wanting the Antichrist to come. The second point of the message is this. There is a real devil. He's real. And he's using everything in his power to trick you kids to take you to hell. There's a heaven and there's a hell. Now look at me. There's a heaven, there's a hell, and the devil's doing everything he can to get you there. You ain't in no playground. There's a battle going on for your soul, boys. And the devil's trying to take you to hell. You better watch him. He ain't going to come up to you and say, with horns, you know, and a pitchfork, say, "Pooh, I'm the devil. Follow me and I'll take you to hell." He comes coated. Good friend of mine, they sing this song a minute ago. It reminds me of Billy Kelly. He's an evangelist. And Billy Kelly's from South Carolina. He's a great big preacher, and he loves to eat. And it reminds me of how the devil will give you something, and it sounds good, and it feels good, and it makes you high. But boy, when it'll do something to you. And old Billy Kelly said he's in the hospital one time visiting this lady, and she's an old woman. She's in a coma, and he's sitting there waiting for her to come around. And he looked over there, and lo and behold, beside her bed was a bowl of peanuts. And so he picked up one of them peanuts and ate it and chewed it up there. Man, them's pretty good. He was waiting there a minute, reached over, got another one of them peanuts, put it in his mouth and chewed it. And before long, he had eaten that entire bowl of peanuts. And finally, that old lady kind of drowsed around there a little bit and come around and looked at him. And she said, "Oh, hey, preacher." And he got talking to her a little bit, and he said, "Ma'am, God bless you. Before I go, ma'am, I got to tell you something. I sit here and eat your whole bowl of peanuts. I sure am sorry about that." And she looked at him. She said, "Oh, that's all right, preacher." She said, "Since they took my teeth out, I can't eat them no way. I just sucked the chocolate off of them." Doing to some of y'all. He's giving you something that you think, "Boy, I like this." And one of these days after it's in your gut, it's too late to get it out then, and you'll realize what you swallowed. And you better look out. You better look out. The boogeyman's after you. And I call him the boogeyman on purpose. He teaches you to boogie. All right, get the light. Got my bulb on there, brother? Flip it up. Now, you're going to hear some things maybe you've never heard tonight, and I'm going to try to get through it briefly and quickly, but we're going to try to give you a message on this tonight. The devil's religion. And you listen real carefully. I believe I'm going to need this one on here just a hair, boys. This one over the piano that dims, maybe just a little bit. Yeah, I believe that'll do it. Thank you. You're going to feel a weird spirit that you didn't feel a while ago when those kids were singing. Every one of you know what that spirit is. Sounds they never heard 50 years ago. Plan is to get everybody together. His job is put that on there on purpose. Let you hear a little bit of that for a reason. And the reason is this. That was gospel music you just heard. Yes, sir. You don't believe it? That's a new group called Striper. And they're playing in churches and in Christian concerts all over the United States. I'm going to show you a picture of them in a minute. That was, you say, what was that? That's what they call gospel rock. And those guys claim to be Christian. They get their name Striper from Isaiah 53. By his stripes, we are healed. And I want to show you some things about them tonight. They don't even claim to be rock and roll singers. They claim to be gospel singers. Now, you couldn't tell that. You couldn't tell that, could you? All right? I'm going to show you some things tonight you want to remember. The first thing is a pentagram. You see that pentagram? That is a universal symbol of Satan worship. Whenever you see a pentagram, whether you know it or not, it got one tattooed on your arm or up on the ceiling of your bedroom, that is a universal sign of Satan worship. And when they have a ritual in a satanic church, they have pictures of it. The priest, the satanic priest, will stand inside that pentagram and perform the rituals, and you'll see more about that in a minute. You see, this here is the goat of Mendes, also a symbol of worshiping Satan, and his face is going to be made into a pentagram, as you see here, and his number is 666. You're going to see another sign throughout the presentation. This is an upside-down cross, meaning that we reject everything that Christianity stands for or believes in. So whenever you see somebody with an upside-down cross around their neck, they are saying, I am for the devil and the Antichrist and against Jesus Christ. You're going to see this sign right here. If you can't see it, it looks like this. And that's the sign they're using at the football games now. It's also a sign that means pledge allegiance to the devil. You say, oh, it does not. You just hold your horses just a second. I'm going to show you a picture of a man here who started the Satan Church in San Francisco, Los Angeles, in that area out there. His name is Anton LaVey. Now, this picture showed Hell Comes to Your House. That's the front of an album. They said it, not me. This is a picture of the Satanic Bible written by Anton LaVey. He played the devil in the movie Rosemary's Baby. He has the pentagram on the front of it with the goat's head in the middle. And this Bible was published in 1969. There's a date you want to remember. 1969, the first rock concert, Woodstock, was put on up north. In 1969, man put his foot on the moon, a type of the church. In 1969, the homosexual revolution began on Christopher Street in New York City in June of that year. In 1969, they begin to sing, they begin to say, God is dead. And this song we're going to deal with in a little bit, Hotel California and Stairway to Heaven, talks about, we have not had that spirit here since 1969. So there's a date you want to remember. Here's the fellow that put it together, and you see his sign that the cheerleaders and football players give at the games now on his left hand. We're going to talk about a man by the name of Aleister Crowley. How many of you have ever heard of Aleister Crowley? Raise your hand. Aleister Crowley was a man who lived over in London many, many years ago. He was called the Beast. The man was so wicked, he was filthy. He lived in all kinds of ungodliness. The Beatles sung about him. Other groups sing openly about Aleister Crowley. He is pictured in many, many rock songs and magazines. The Beatles had a song, a picture of him on their Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Heart Club Band album. And they had all kinds of things for this man, Aleister Crowley. Aleister Crowley got an old mansion over in London, and it has the world's largest occult bookstore, and Jimmy Page now owns that mansion and lives in it. How many of you know who Jimmy Page is? All right, you know who I'm talking about. He is the lead guitar player for Led Zeppelin on one of the most famous rock songs of all time, Stairway to Heaven. And this man, Anton LaVey, inspired by these fellas. Here's the album, Stairway to Heaven. I'm in Hotel California, and I want to show you Anton LaVey inside this album jacket. It's talking about, by the way, this is on California Street. this thing begins. Can any good thing come out of California? You better believe it can. All right? Now, look at here. Look at here. All this thing come, all these people down in here, and I don't know if you can see it from where you are. It's a long way. But right here in this middle window, you see a face. And on the song it says, such a lovely place, such a lovely face. You want a close-up? There he is. It's Anton LaVey, the beginner of the Satan Church. There's the group I let you hear a minute ago. These guys are doing Christian concerts all over the United States. You see these little books they got in their hands? Them's New Testaments that they throw out over the crowd when they give their presentation. Divinity, drums, and rock and roll. They went on a tour not long ago called the Heaven and Hell Tour with Striper versus Wasp. Now, you parents here, look at this. This group Wasp here, led by this fellow Blackie Lawless, you see these periods, W-A-S-P, period, 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 meaning these letters represent something. It's written on the album what it represents. We are sex perverts. That's what the name Wasp means. I can show it to you on their album. And so these fine Christian fellows go in together and go on tour with them and go all over creation on the Heaven and Hell Crusade. And I sure like what Brother Ruckman says, birds of a feather flock together. There's Wasp. And you see a lot of things on them. I'm just talking to you now. We'll get the message here in a minute. Here's what they say on the back of their album. You don't think rock and roll is a religion? The gods you worship are steel. At the altar of rock and roll, you kneel. Here's a group, you know Ozzy Osbourne? Ozzy Osbourne has become famous by, when he go into a concert, before he'd do it, they'd have all kind of satanic rituals. He would take a live bat and bite his head off. And he was supposed to be on a TV special, and he couldn't because he got rabies from the bat. And he's got all kinds of wild things. The man is cuckoo, brother. And the name of the album is The Ultimate Sin. We'll talk more about Ozzy. Here he is, the Blizzard of Oz. He's constantly fooling with a cross. He's constantly blaspheming God. And he's now being sued because of his song promoting suicide. And he calls the young man. He tells you to lay down in the bed, put the gun to your head. Suicide is the only way out, that type of thing, and describes in detail how to kill yourself. And there's parents across the nation, different places, I think, suing him right now for causing their kids to kill herself. Here's a guy named Billy Idol, and I just want you to see inside this rock magazine. Billy Idol, is this man God? I'm a big fan of Billy Idol. I think he's God. Y'all know Kiss, won't spend much time on them. One thing I want you to point out is this. The lightning-shaped S's. And you'll keep seeing that look like a strike of lightning coming down. And it's got a lot to do with the devil, because the Lord said, I beheld Satan as lightning fall from heaven. And there's some other things I'm going to show you about those lightning bolts in a minute. Here's an album by Black Sabbath. This is a group that continually blasphemes the Lord in front of thousands of young people every year, and up in Canada had a concert in which, before they started, had an invitation for young people to come down and give their lives to Satan. Yes, sir. Now, you see here, the first thing you see up here is a cross, X out. Then you look down here and you see another cross, and if you look close, right in the middle, you see a picture of a devil's head. Here's his eyes, here's his nose, here's his lips, and there's his horns. Can you see it? Here's their next album, Bloody Sabbath. It's a satanic ritual in which a nude body is being sacrificed to the devil. The rats are coming, the demons are here, the snake and serpent around his neck, tormented by these winged, wicked, ungodly creatures, with a skull over him and the number 666. Here's their other album called Born Again. This is a picture of a baby demon. And they are saying that it's like the sons of God saw the daughters of men. that they were fair to look upon. And you, folks, I'm about ready to bust right now because there's so much I want to say to you. I tell you, brother, this thing is coming faster and faster. All they're talking about is some supernatural creature coming down and cohabitating with human being women and producing some kind of a supernatural baby devil. Here's a picture of Christ crucified on a dollar bill. No cross. In God we trust. Blasphemy by the dead Kennedys, also blaspheming the Kennedy family. Hey, it's come a long way since I want to hold your hand, mamas and dads. It's come a long way from bebopping down at Arnold's and getting milkshakes and where are we going to go tonight, baby? We passed the drugs and the booze and the sex tape. We're into worship now. And if I didn't know we had the right book and the right religion any other way, I would know it by they can't leave it alone. They don't sing anything about Buddha. They don't sing anything about Muhammad. It's always Jesus Christ. Why? They won't leave him alone because the Holy Ghost won't leave them alone. Let's look closer. You see the marks that are on everything you buy at the store? What do you see in the middle of them? All right, Christ on parade. Why would they want to name a record that? You see the upside down cross in blaspheming the Lord Jesus Christ. I don't know if you can see it, but here's a cross with the American flag wrapped around it. And a various stickers, a swastika and all kind of $5 bill, and a busted TV and things like that, all down, a little baby there wrapped up, and all kinds of weird things that God knows what means. Here's these fellas here that's kind of out of style right now, but they were real popular, and they kept their name AC/DC. How many of you know what AC/DC? Have you ever had a tape player that would either run off AC or DC? You know what that means? It can operate either way. You can be a queer or you can be straight. It don't matter if they got a boy, it don't matter if they got a girl, whichever, you know. AC/DC, that's what it means. They got the lightning strike in between them. And these fellas, Bon Scott wrote the song, started the album, Highway to Hell. Now, these guys are open and blatant about what they're saying. And he said, as you well know, I am on the highway to hell. And we're going to hear the words for that song. Nobody's going to slow me down. Got my wheel. Like a wheel. Going to spin it.
Going to spin it.
Nobody going to mess me around. I'm on the highway to hell. What the boys are saying? He said, I'm on the highway to hell, and nobody ain't gonna stop me. Nobody gonna slow me down. Hey, Satan. Hey, Jews. I'm playing in a rocking band. Hey, mama, look at me. I'm on my way to the promised land. And what a lot of you kids don't know is Bon Scott, just a few weeks after he wrote that song, he made it. And he was partying too much and puking too hard and went to hell. You say, why do these guys sing about going to hell, preacher? Because the devil has told them that if they'll live for him, they will rule in hell and not burn. Now, the reason rock and roll singers are so popular is they have made a covenant with Satan, and they'll say, the devil will say, hey, you'll go to hell, but you won't burn. You'll help me run the show. And they're deceived in believing him, and they're deceived and being deceived while they deceive you. There's your other album, AC/DC, If You Want Blood. Back of the album, you've got it. Some other things I could say, but we'll move on. This is a group called Running Wild, Gates to Purgatory. And I'll talk more about that in a minute, but still on this fella's arm, three crosses upside down, on his arm tattooed, 666. There's a close-up picture of it. This album, Devil Child. Now here you see this little baby born in what looks like some kind of satanic ritual. What'd I say? Devil Child? Who they talking about? Look at the back of the album. Here's your pentagram. The name of the song, Devil Child. Reign of Terror, Son of a Witch, Repent or Die. And down here, the words are so filthy that I could not even read them to you. Here's a group, Rising Force, marching out. This fella here, I'm going to show you what a young girl said about him. They have a song here, the Disciples of Hell. In the darkness they will gather, conjuring the one. Listen. Conjuring the one. They're trying to conjure up something. Burning candles, incantations, human sacrifice. Getting drunk from blood, not wine. Pointed daggers shine. Out of the fire, smoking brimstone, the dreaded one will rise. Did you know 60 or 80% of the major denominations in America don't even know the dreaded one's going to arise? And these guys know it. Did you know these guys know who Leviathan is? And about 80% of preachers in Pensacola thinks he's a hippopotamus? Looky here, folks. Nobody knows who's the disciples of hell. Father's a priest. He's casting a spell. No one can stop what's already begun. Worshiping darkness and Lucifer's son. That's what they're singing to your boys and girls. You say, well, they just get in there and turn it up in the room, and it's so loud, I can't understand it. And your boys and girls have got in there, and they can open the album jacket and read right along, word for word, what's being said. And that's how the devil slips it in under mom and daddy's nose. And you wonder why they won't mind. And you wonder why they don't want to go to church. Here's what a girl said about that boy. I can't tell you that. She wants to rape him. And it said down here, face it, the man is God. Angel witch. You can't see this, but down here is hell. Looks like a big city up here, and these people look like angel people with wings and stuff like that. There's the back of the album. You see the goat of Mendes used in devil worship. You see the two fingers? Now looky there. He's a-doing this. That'll preach. You see the pentagram right between his eyes. And the name of the songs are just too much. Here's a sweet little boy everybody likes. And all you girls think, oh, he's just the greatest. And you think, no, you ain't going to get nothing like that on him. But I want to show you a picture of him here. And he's here with a goat ring on his little finger. Here's a group called Slayer. First of all, you see it in the middle of the pentagram. The second thing you notice is the name of the album is Honing the Chapel. The next thing you notice is the name Slayer. It stands for Satan Last as You Eternally Rot. It's on the album. I can show it to you. Satan Last as You Rot in Hell. Look at the name of the song. Look at the words to that song, Honing the Chapel. The ghosts of sin torment the priest. Their altar will soon be destroyed. Heaven's palace turning black. The church now belongs to the dead. Blackened magic infest with lust. Lucifer rules supreme. The crystal ball shows unknown fate. The last thing that's heard is the scream. Ghosts from hell invade the feeble shrine. Heaven's holy house will fail in time. Satan's morbid soldiers chant in lust. Destruction of the church will burn the cross. Now, you get up, you talk about me for criticizing them. Look what they're saying about us. They're wanting to burn our church. Down here, attacking angels as they pray to God, tormented preachers, hell, a twisted cross, haunting the chapel, hell, that hell's demons prevail. Death has come, the house of God has failed. Look at the name of this song, folks. The name of the song, the Antichrist. What's this? Screams and nightmares on a life I want. Can't see a living this light, no world I haunt. You've lost all control of my heart and soul. Satan holds my future. Watch it unfold. I am the Antichrist. What about that? What about people getting up and singing, I am the Antichrist? Listen, whatever happened to just singing, I love you, baby, and will you be my baby, and is you is or is you ain't my baby, you know, all that stuff. Whatever happened to twist and shout? Now they're up saying, I am the Antichrist. Lord help, man. I like what the preacher said. We're at the jumping off place. I ain't through. I am the Antichrist. It's what I was meant to be. Your God left me behind. Who's that sound like? Judas Iscariot. And set my soul to be free. Watching disciples of the satanic rule, pentagram of blood holds the jackal's truth. Searching for the answer, Christ hasn't come. Awaiting the final moment, the birth of Satan's son. See the back of this record? The name of the song? The Antichrist. Die by the blood. All kinds of things like that. Slayer. Satan laughs as you eternally rot. Side one. Six. Side two. Six, six. Here's the other album by Slayer, Show No Mercy. Where in the world do they come up with stuff like that? Who is laying it on their heart? There's your other album, Hell Awaits. Don't you think they can find something else to sing about? They preach more than we are. They're more fanatical than we are about that book. You did notice they didn't say Sheol Awaits. We'd get as smart as they are, we might preach. They're more blunt than us preachers. There's another Slayer album, Rain and Blood. Look at the name of this song, Jesus Saves. You want me to read it to you? Here's what the kids hear. You go to church, you kiss the cross. Boy, stuff like that's coming up a lot. Kissing crosses and virgin blood we'll get on that in a minute. You'll be saved at any cost. You have your own reality, Christianity. You spend your life, can't read it, a trait that's grown as time has passed. You think the world will end today. You praise the Lord, it's all you say. The name of this album, Possessed, the name of the group. They have the serpent's tail, the upside down cross. The name of this special album is Seven Churches. Look at it. Look at the back of this album, man. Name of the songs: The Exorcist, Pentagram, Burning in Hell, Evil Warriors, Seven Churches, Satan's Curse, Holy Hell, Twisted Minds, Fallen Angel. Upside Down Cross. And there's old Ronnie James Dio. And this fellow's real popular right now. And you see this. You see a great big some kind of a demon devil with a chain, and he's coming like this, going to wrap up this religious-looking fella here and tie him up. I'm going to make a statement some of you ain't going to like. We have now demonstrated that all these groups, when they see religion, they see Catholicism. That's what they see. They don't see King James Bible, even old time, independent, fundamental. They don't see them. They see the Catholic Church. They see the hypocrisy. They see the fake. They see the junk. And we come to a great truth. The Catholic Church is responsible for much of the devil worship in the world. And in her was found the blood of the saints and all them that were slain upon the earth. You know what Madonna started out to be? A nun.
Yeah, that's right.
When they think of church, they think of guys that look like that. When we see guys look like that, it don't even remind us of church.
Yeah.
There he is. The name of the album, The Last in Line. You know what he said in that song? He said, we'll know for the first time if we're human or divine, we're the last in line. He's saying, of all the generations that's been on this earth, we're the last one. You see the devil here? Can you see his hands, kids? You know what he's doing? He's doing this with both hands. And he's got these people down here in the fire, tormenting them in hell. You see that? Same thing. Here's a group called Sad Iron. I'm going to let you hear a little music right now by this group called Slayer that I showed you a minute ago. And I don't know what you think about backmasking. If you're like me, when I first heard about it, I said, that's the biggest bunch of junk I ever heard of. They told me, they said, on some of them rock and roll songs, you can play them backwards, and they have secret messages in them. I said, oh, you're crazy. I said, good night, you're liable to play when we all get to heaven backwards, and it cuts. I don't know. I don't know about all that stuff. You know why I said that? I said that because I was ignorant. And I began to think about that thing, and I have preached for years that the devil makes things go backwards. God said, don't eat the fruit. The devil says, go ahead and eat it. God says, husbands, love your wives. The devil says, love somebody else's wife. The Lord says, children, obey your parents. The devil says, you don't have to do a thing they say. Amen? All right. The devil makes things go backwards. What'd he do when he got them pigs and them 2,000 herd of swine? They turned around, ran down a steep place. A farmer told me, he said, you can't make a hog run downhill. Hogs don't run downhill. Their head's too big. You know, which way you take them, they'll turn and go up a hill. They bust their nose run downhill. But when the devil got in them, they turned around, ran down the hill, and jumped off the ocean and committed hogicide. That's the first case in the Bible of devil ham. And the demons didn't drown, brother. The hogs drowned. The demons come out soaking wet on the other side and stuck up a sign and said, the Church of Christ meets here, water saved. But anyway. I just couldn't resist that. Now hang with us. Don't leave. If you leave tonight, we're going to know what kind you are. You got some guts? Stay with us. I want to let you hear something by that group Slayer a minute ago. And I want to show you a little bit of backmasking. Some of it's real clear, some of it's not too clear. But I want you to listen real carefully. This is forward. That's playing it straight. In a moment, we're going to play it backwards. Backwards. That was forward, man. I don't ever know it, would you? You know what it says backwards? Join us. Join us. Join us. Ago, and they're going to say this. That's You want to hear that backwards? It says this. Well, you'll leave then. It says this. There is a city not far from here. The earth is near, the sky is black. Sell your soul to the Lord's pentagram. There is a city not far from here. Did you hear it? Now, we're getting warmed up now. And I want to show you this group here. They make no bones about it. You may be sitting there tonight saying, oh, preacher, that's a gimmick. They're doing that to make money. I'm going to prove to you that these guys believe what they're saying. They are some of them that are fake and just using this gimmick to get rich quick. But a lot of these groups totally believe in what they're singing about. This group sings about praising the devil. And they have a song, We All Praise the Devil. You see the cross on the back? Here's the song. You see it? We all praise the devil. He is so fine. We all praise the devil till the day we die.
Ooh, it's so nice.
Here it comes. We all praise the devil.
We all
the group Sad Iron. Here's Iron Maiden. You know the group. A lot of it. Peace of Mind shows this weird-looking character in this chain. And there they are sitting on the back, getting ready to have dinner. And lo and behold, dinner is a human brain. Ain't that the kind of guys you girls would like to date? If it is, you're an idiot. Here's Iron Maiden, the name of this album, The Number of the Beast. How many of you know where that comes from? Revelation 13, The Number of the Beast. You have this guy, you know who that dude right there is? That's Eddie. You know who Eddie is? He is their imaginary mascot, who is not imaginary. He's real, and they don't even realize it. And Eddie here has this puppet on strings controlling this demon with a pitchfork. And he's got these millions of people, it looks like, down here, burning in hell. Can you see them little figures? Let me get a close-up of that if we can. Back one time here. Here, you see these? There's a girl falling in hell. There's people by the hundreds in hell. Little figures like this just writhing in the fire. And you see this lightning and everything like it's a picture of the devil raining over hell. And here's what these guys are promised. The devil promised them that if they'll be true to him, that when they get to hell, they'll be like this, and all these other people be down here burning, and that's why see these people falling and burning in hell? That ain't like a fire. That's before they get there. And these guys are told that they're going to rule, but what they don't know is the devil don't keep his promises. And when they get to hell, they're going to be reduced to one of these suffering souls, just like anybody else, and the devil has won the battle, and they were tricked, and it's too late to do anything about it. Woe unto you, earth and sea. The devil sends wrath because he knows he has a short time. Him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is a human number, that's weird, is the number of 666. Isn't that a weird thing to put on a rock album? Wonder what that is. You may think I'm crazy, but I believe everything we've seen on here tonight looking like that really exists. They getting that idea from somewhere. Motley Crue. The first thing you see, the pentagram. The name of the album, Shout at the Devil. Do you kids know what Shout at? I hear some of you quoting it down here. Do you know what that album means, boys? Shout at the Devil means if we holler and play our music loud enough and shout at the devil, he'll send his antichrist. Here you see him on the back of the album, in the middle of the pentagram, where the satanic priest stands to perform his black mass, and his all kind of filthy stuff up there. There they are. Are they cursed? You better believe it. Here's a group called Destruction. Now look at them dudes, son. Ain't that cute? You see, the first thing you notice is an upside down cross around their neck. That means we reject Christianity. On the back of the album, the end is near. Lucifer's legions of death are ready for attack. They've only got one aim, total destruction. We've got the filthy word blocked out. And you see a song in a minute, or you're going to hear a song called Sacrifice to the Devil. And it goes like this, by this group here called Tyrant, Legions of the Dead. And I'm going to let you hear the words, and I'm going to tell them to you so you can listen and get them. Candles glow, demonic haze. Virgin's blood, satanic craze. Life means nothing to his Lord. Virgin's blood is finally poured. Pentagram, bloodshed. Virgin's dead, and giants walk. That's interesting, isn't it? Giants walk. Did you know there were giants in those days that I was talking about a minute ago back in Genesis 6? And let me tell you something, brethren. They ain't singing about the son, godly line of Seth. These giants are walking around. Manute Bone, people like that. The name of the songs are Warriors of Metal, Into the Hands of Evil. Look at the name of this song, The Battle of Armageddon. Tyrants, Revelation. Look at the name of this one, Listen to the Preacher. Smartest thing they said all night. Look at this one, Sacrifice. You want to hear it? Sacrifice for the Devil. It's going to say, be quiet now, Sacrifice for the Devil. Sacrifice for the Devil. Rejoice for your sins. Sacrifice for the Devil. This ain't no dream. And then I'm going to let you hear something else. We're going to get a little harder now. Candles glow. They've got only one aim, total destruction. Now look at the words of this song. Demonic pain, virgin's blood, satanic praise, life means nothing to his Lord. Virgin's blood is finally poured. Virgin's dead. Pentagram, bloodshed. Virgin's dead. And giants walk. all these, a lot of these little kids are turning up missing? You know why there's cows and dogs and stuff missing all over the cities of America? Hey, man, they're putting it on TV, 60 Minutes, all kind of, they're having specials on people who actually carry through with this stuff, drinking blood, killing people. And if the truth is known, and I don't know it, but if the truth is known, it's going on right here in Pensacola. Now, I'll let you hear something. What you're going to hear now, there's a group, see this dude coming right out of the smoke out of the middle of the pentagram? See the name of the song? Power from where? Where do they say the power is coming from? Here's a group called Venom, very popular. What is venom? It's poison out of a snake. Now look at this. You see the goat's head, the goat of Mendes. Right here in the center of his forehead is the pentagram. In this ear, he has an earring. It's an upside-down cross. In this ear, he has an earring, 666. Over here is the pentagram, upside-down cross. And they say on the record, let the spirit guide the mind till Manitou ascends. Who's Manitou? It's an Indian god spirit that they worship. Look at this group called Venom. Welcome to hell. The goat face, the pentagram. There's the name of the song. 1,000 Days in Sodom. Angel dust. In league with Satan, in nomine Satana, that in the name of Satan, I think in Latin. Now, I want you to look at something here. We are possessed by all that is evil. The death of you, God, we demand. We spit at the virgin you worship and sit at Lord Satan's left hand. You don't think we're near the end? Did you mom and daddy hear anything like that on the radio when you was growing up? Hear anything like that 10 years ago? No. No. I want to show you something about this outfit. I hate the groups, this guy here. I hate the groups who make a mockery at what we've done. There are groups who sing about exorcism and satanic rites who know nothing about those subjects. They're just looking for publicity. We believe totally in the music we play and the subjects we sing about. Look at that. American assault and a picture of some kind of dead cow bone or something eating up the American flag. 50 years ago, that wouldn't even been allowed to put on a shelf in America. Exodus, the name of this group. Now, ain't that a picture? Bonded by blood. And all kinds of implications there that we'll not go into. And you see special thanks on the back of here to Satan's choir. I'm going to let you hear Satan's choir. First, you're going to hear them whisper, I want your soul. And then you're going to hear Satan's choir. Or the whisper comes just leave. There they are. That don't sound like a monkey to me, man. That don't sound like a monkey. There's your group. They said special thanks. want your soul. Let me stop right there just a minute and say something. I skipped this whisper back there just a moment ago. What you're going to hear now is one of the scariest things I've ever heard in my life. You boys be quiet down here now and listen real carefully. It's not a joke. This is a group called Merciful Fate. You see a picture of some kind of creature pointing out of flames, telling somebody not to break the oath. Somebody's made an oath, and he's telling them not to break it. And we find out on the back inside the album who the oath was to. The back of the album shows some kind of old castle, like a satanic worship place, with this guy here named King Diamond. And King Diamond, being a satanic priest, can never show his real face, they say. And you see the upside down crosses. Look at the name. Gone in the Sabbath, come in the Sabbath, welcome Princess of Hell, the oath, which we'll hear now in a minute, night of the unborn, destruction of, desecration of soul, nightmare, and things like that. There he is, the man that sings it, with a cross here made out of bones on his microphone, and you're going to hear a real life, honest to goodness, satanic ritual where a man makes a vow to give his soul to the devil. Buddy, this ain't funny. Now, you boys and you girls, you can say, well, I ain't gonna let him change my mind, always, and you'll make a fool out of yourself one of these days. I love you, and this church cares about you, and that's why we've got you here tonight. You say, well, you don't sound like you love me. I'm trying to shock you in the reality that the Lord's coming soon, and if you're not ready, you'll be left behind. Look at the word. I'll let you hear it in a minute. By the symbol of the Creator, I swear, henceforth to be a faithful servant of his most puissant archangel, the Prince Lucifer, whom the Creator designated as his regent, the Lord of this world. Amen. I deny Jesus Christ, the deceiver, and I abjure the Christian faith, holding in contempt all of its works. Now, don't you listen to this fellow's voice. I don't believe any man's voice could change like this man's voice changed without some kind of supernatural power. You're going to hear, when he gets right there to all its works, you're going to hear his voice completely take another form. He's singing real high, where he says, holding in contempt, and then he just something like it comes into him, and he says all of its works. You'll now hear it. You the words as you listen. You don't think that we're in a dangerous time. It's time some of you people got your head out of the sand. Some of you Christian boys and girls got your life right with God. Got on fire for God. Just because you're a teenager don't give you no excuse to live like a devil. About how hard it is. My friends make fun of me. I got better sense to wind up in a crowd like this. Come a long way, ain't we? Since Elvis the Beach Boy. There's Dee Snider, a twisted sister. I don't know where they got a name like Twisted Sister. I figured that must be a lesbian nun. I'd tell something funny there to get that evil spirit out of here. Stay hungry. You only know what he sings about? Burning hell. Let's hear him. He says, "Welcome you to the abandoned land. Come on in, child, take my hand. Here there's no work or play, only one bill to pay." You know what that bill is? You got to pay in hell, don't you? That's for your sins. Jesus paid for them on the cross, but you wouldn't accept it. And when you go to hell, then you got to pay for it, brother. And an eternal sin against an eternal God don't never get paid for, so you got to stay there forever and ever and ever and ever and ever. Here there's only one bill to pay. There's just five words to say as you go down, down, down. You're going to burn in hell. Here we go. Let me play you another news. Grim Reaper. You see the Grim Reaper here on his horse of death coming to take you away? The name of the album? See you in hell, fellas. They ain't joking. Let me quote you the words of this song. You girls listen real careful. Can I make you an offer? You can't refuse. I've kept my eye on you because I knew that you're loose. The devil knows a loose girl or a loose boy, and he said, "I kept my eye on you. Can I take you to the place you know so well? I'll take you to the very gates of hell. See you in hell, my friend." Here it goes. By the way, listen to this. Forward. That was forward. This album's called See You in Hell. That was forward. You don't hear that backwards? See if you can hear what he said. Here's backwards. That's backwards, brother! See you in hell. Here we go. Can I make you an offer that you can't refuse? I've kept my eye on you because I knew you're loose. Thank you.
motorcycle. Fear no evil. Here's a letter from a young lady who wrote to this magazine. I used to be drunk or stoned 24 hours a day and live my life in the fast lane. One night after a party, my boyfriend, me, and my best friend were driving home. The car went out of control. My friend was killed instantly. My boyfriend and I were seriously injured. Since then, we have recovered physically but not mentally. I'm in counseling, and my boyfriend are in a drug rehab. Just a word of caution. Now, your choice tonight is the Lord Jesus Christ or a burning hell. Now, the devil wants to take every young man and every young lady in here tonight and kill them and take them to hell. We had an accident in our city that I'm going to show you a picture of. And in this car wreck one night, I'd been off somewhere and I came home and found out about it. There were five teenage boys drinking beer and in the car. They come down the road at a high rate of speed in excess of, they say, 90 miles an hour. They ran off a curb and literally wrapped that car around that tree, and five boys died, just like these young men sitting up here tonight. Five of them died just like that. If I've ever seen a picture of a demon, there's one. Do you want to live forever and ever and ever with something that looks like that? Do you want to stay in a place where there's screaming and burning and fire and brimstone forever? These boys had this car wreck. This is a newspaper photograph. You see how the tree has just literally got the car wrapped around it. Look where the steering wheel is. Here you see legs and feet and arms. See that hand sticking out of the car? There was beer, smell of beer and blood all over the place. That's what the devil will do to you. You hear me tonight? That's what the devil will do to you. All five of them died instantly, and they said, they were told me, I can't prove this, they told me the song Highway to Hell tape was in the tape player. It threw out of the tape player and actually threw a boy's stomach. They were going down the highway playing the Highway to Hell. And I'm afraid the boys made it. They weren't saved by the grace of God. The old church you passed by week after week after week answer for your soul. The old gospel preacher with a Bible can tell you how to get out of hell. You'll wind up like that with that guy one of these days.
I'm burning hell.
here to tell you tonight, friend, this is serious business. And I want you to look real carefully at what you're looking at. There's only one answer for this old sin-cursed world, and it happened on a cross 2,000 years ago. And the man walked up an old rugged hill with a big old burly cross on his shoulder. He hung his head and cried, "It is finished."
Are
you going to hear a different spirit come in here now?
Filled with blood drawn from Emmanuel's veins.
That happened so you wouldn't have to go. And Alice Cooper. That night I stood back there at the back of the church. My hair was way down here. I had a flag sewn on my pants. Five lost on my way to hell. All that night, God, the Holy Ghost, began to deal with my heart. And I knew I was going to hell if I didn't get saved, kid. I wouldn't take $1 million, but that night I stepped out of my seat, walked down here, I got down and said, "Oh, God, buddy, I don't have to go to hell now because of what the Lord done for me." And you don't either, you don't either. You don't have to go to hell. Come on, get up out of your seat and come and pray. Come on. What they'll say, just get out of your seat and come right now. Let's let the Lord do something for us tonight. Let God speak to your heart tonight, friend. One of these days when this poor lisping, stammering tongue lies silent in the grave, it'll all be over with. God wants to do something for you tonight. Get up out of your seat, girl. Come on, get up. Don't you be ashamed. Don't you hold back. You let God Almighty do something in your life tonight. Don't you be ashamed. Just get up out of your seat. Don't be a fool. Don't be a fool. The Lord wants to save you tonight. That's right. Some of you ladies, make sure all these girls get somebody to pray with, will you? Ladies. All you three people that are Christians, just try to pray right there at your seat. Let the Lord speak to you tonight. Let God Almighty do a work in your soul. That right there is the reason you don't have to go to hell, boys. That right there is the reason you don't have to go to the place where you'll never live or never die, but burn forever and ever and ever. You don't want to live with something like that. It's called the amazing grace of God. Amen. Come on, come on. Just get up out of your seat. Come on, girl. There's a bunch of you girls right in there just a-crying. You're fighting off the Holy Ghost conviction. Just get up out of your seat. Come on, come on. Come on, get up out of your seat. It'll only take a trip down here. Confess the Lord Jesus Christ as your Savior. Come on. Get up here, boys. Up back. Can you get it up a little bit? A little bit more, please. Good. Come on. Come on. Everybody stand. Everybody stand. Let's stand. Just get out of your seat, young people. Hallelujah. Thank God for grace of God. Come on. Make sure all these young people get somebody to deal with them. Come on, get out of your seat. Keep coming. That's right. Here comes some more. Here comes some more. Let the Holy Spirit of God get a hold of you tonight, friend. Come on. Well, be on there. You kids? Teenagers? How about it, Christian? Come on. Come on. Come on. Let the Holy Spirit of God speak to you tonight. Get out of your seat tonight and come. Yeah, come on. Come on. Come on. Let God get a hold of your heart. Tomorrow may be too late. There's plenty of room if you need to come. There's preachers here that love you. They can take a Bible and show you how to get saved. Please don't leave. Please don't leave. The Lord loves you tonight. He wants to help you. Come on. Come on right now. That's right. Thank God the Lord's still moving. Lord's still moving. Here comes some more. Hallelujah. Glory to God, mama. Woo-hoo! Glory, isn't that a blessed sight? Oh, you mama's got it made. Let's see them boys and girls on the altar. You mama's ought to shout the roof off this building. My boy and girl saved. My boy and girl living for God. Oh, what a blessed, wonderful thing. Softly, I want to ask you a question tonight before we turn the service over to the preacher and we go. I wonder how many of you kids here tonight, a lot of these have got saved, a lot of them turned their life over to Jesus. I wonder how many of you tonight, while some still coming, will say, preacher, I'm not saved. I'm not saved here tonight. And the Lord has spoke to my heart. And I'm not saved and I don't want to go to hell. And I want this church to pray for me. I want you and Brother Ruckman, Brother McGahee, and these preachers to pray for me. I didn't come to the altar tonight, but I want you to pray for me. I'm not going to heaven. I want you to raise your hand. Raise your hand. Heads are bowed, eyes are closed. Anywhere in the building, just raise your hand. God bless you, son. Thank you for having enough guts to raise your hand. Teenage boy. Somebody else, raise it real high where I can see it. We're not going to embarrass you. Nobody's going to come to you. We're just going to pray for you. Anybody else? God bless you. Anybody else? Anybody else? Raise that hand. Raise that hand real high tonight. Say, preacher, I'm not saved. God bless you, young man. There's another one. Anybody else? I see your hand back there, brother. All right. Anybody else? Anybody else? Raise your hand. I see your hand back there, sir. God bless you. I see your hand over here on my left. God bless you. Thank you for being honest tonight. Now, God loves you. God loves you. Who else? Raise your hand. Raise your hand over here. Anywhere. Anywhere. Raise your hand. If you say, I'm not saved, but I do want you to pray for me. I don't want to go to hell. Please pray for me. Raise your hand. Raise your hand right quick. Raise your hand. Anywhere in the building, we're going to pray. God bless you, young man. I see your hand. Anybody else? Anybody else? Raise your hand. Say, preacher, I ain't saved, but I do want you to pray for me. Anyone else? Raise it real high so I can see it. I see your hand over here, young lady. Anybody else? I see your hand, ma'am. I see your hand, young man. All right, anybody else? That's right. I see your hand back there. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for being honest. Now, this won't save you, but it's going to help us to pray for you. Let me ask you before we go tonight, please, don't you want to get that thing settled? Don't you want to say when you walk out these doors tonight, I am saved? We want every Christian in here tonight to pray just for a minute. And you that lifted your hands, why don't you walk on down here to this altar and let's get saved tonight? Why don't you get saved tonight, friend? Come on, come on. Just walk out of your seat and come. Well, there you go. Thank God for this young man. Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody else. Somebody else. You raise your hand tonight. Come on, just get out of your seat. Don't walk out these doors lost without God and without hope. Hell forever and ever and ever and ever. Why don't you get out of your seat and come? We'll wait just a few seconds. We ain't trying to trick you. We're going to pray for you. And if you want to come and pray with us, just get out of your seat and come right now. Come on. Come on. That's right. Come on. Come on. Just step out of your seat. Let the Lord save you tonight. Don't you wait on somebody else. Don't you wait. Now's your opportunity. Something up here getting things settled. Pianist, would you come quickly? You've had your chance.
Give their heart to God.
Preacher, you come. Never have the Lord lead you.
We'll tire just about a minute. We'll let these finish doing personal work down here. Now, I know it's late tonight, but I'm keeping you just a couple minutes more before you leave here tonight. Now, there's some great stuff you heard tonight, and I appreciate it. That's the best preaching the hell I've heard seen in a long time. I appreciate these unsaved people warning you about what's ahead, because God knows the preachers don't have enough guts to do it anymore. And they gave you a real picture. That's the real thing. Before we leave here tonight, I want to have us all sit down just a minute, please. Now, I'm not going to keep you long. I'll keep you long. 5 minutes, maybe, okay? Now, how many have a Bible on you tonight? Would you raise a hand? All right, now, before we leave here tonight, can we have the rest of them lights, brother? Can we have the rest of them lights? Now, before we leave here tonight, the Bible says, sanctify them with the truth. Thy word is truth. This is the cleansing agent. So if you want to get the demons out of you, get in here. But I'm not going to long thing tonight. We're not going to have a Bible study tonight. God knows we get enough of it during the week. Before we leave here, I'm going to show you 3 verses. If you're a visitor here and wonder what this stuff was about, I'll show you what it's about. These fellows that paint these record jackets and make these songs, they don't know what I'm going to show you. But you see, the Spirit in them knows this book. A fellow said to me one time, he said, Ruckman, he said, do you know anybody in America knows the Bible any better than you know it? And I said, oh, sure, there's probably a lot of them. He said, now, don't give me any false humility. Do you know if anybody knows it better than you know it? And I said, yes. He said, who? I said, the devil. The devil. And I'll take your Bible, turn to Genesis chapter 3. I'm going to show you something. I'm going to show you what you've seen tonight on these rock record jackets. And I'm quoting you here from a book that was published 300 years ago. I'm in Genesis chapter 3. That's right at the beginning. And this is God speaking to the devil. Here's what he says. Genesis 3:15. I put enmity between thee and the woman. There's that virgin. And between thy seed, the seed of the serpent, and her seed. That's a virgin. A woman has no seed. That's a prophecy in the virgin birth. And it, the woman's seed, shall bruise thy head, and thou, the serpent's seed, shall bruise his heel. All right, 2 Corinthians chapter 4. You want to know why he began tonight and talk to you about Satan worship, about the devil being worshipped, and why this rock music went from Preston the Beatles on to this worship stuff? I'll show you why. 2 Corinthians 4, verse 4. I'm quoting from a book written more than 370 years ago. 2 Corinthians 4, verse 4. You want to know why the devil wants worship? It's right there. In whom the God of this world hath blinded the mind of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. You know what Satan's called there? The God of this world. You know what a God wants? He wants worship. Did you just see this thing? This fellow's a god. This fellow's a god. He must. That's the stuff. Now, one more and we're through. Revelation chapter 20. Of course, there's all kind of stuff on this. But you need to see this before you leave here tonight. If you're here tonight and you're unsaved, there's something you better get in your craw, brother, sister, young man, young woman. This old-fashioned King James Bible I've got in my hand is 300 years of any rock group in the country. The rock groups are old-fashioned. I've got the up-to-date stuff right here. All right, Revelation chapter 20, verse 10. And the devil that deceived them. You see that? And the devil that deceived them. You see that car wrapped around that tree? And the devil that deceived them was cast into the lake of fire and brimstone, where the beast and the false prophet are, and shall be tormented. Not even the devil gets out of the torment. It isn't just some special bunch get out and watch the rest of them burn. The one who deceived them burns. For the beast and false prophet are and shall be tormented day and night forever and ever. You better get saved. Better get saved. or let us stand to be dismissed. Now, I don't know all the results we had here tonight. We didn't take cards from the folks, but I'm sure a lot of folks got saved, a lot of folks got right. And the Holy Spirit's been powerful here in these services. This is a twice-a-year Bad Attitude Baptist blowout, and this best one we ever had. And we want to keep it that way now. We got two more services, Sunday morning and Sunday night, tomorrow night. We're not through yet. We're not through watching God work and watching God deal. And I know you're getting a blessing, and I thank God tonight you got a little light on some things. Now, you know what some of y'all do? Y'all do what I did when I got saved. When I got saved, I went home and broke about $500 worth of records. And to make sure nobody played them if they were cracked, I took them out in the back over a burner and melted them so they looked like this. And my goodness, folks, the stuff that I burned was Christian alongside what some of you ought to burn tonight. I melted Artie Shaw and Stan Kenton and Benny Goodman and Tommy Dorsey and Jimmy Dorsey and Fats Waller and Louis Armstrong. Man, alongside the stuff you got back in your place, we was clean folks. Go tonight, throw some of the stuff out. Father, dismiss your blessing. We're thankful for the truth. We're thankful most of all you opened our eyes one day and showed us the truth. And if you hadn't, we'd be in hell. And if we weren't in hell yet, we'd be on the highway to hell. And we're thankful tonight. We know the one who is the way, the truth, and the life. And we ask you to bless upon these that trust you to be their Savior tonight. Give them assurance. Keep these young people clean. May they always have a love for the right kind of music. We ask it in Jesus' name.